Yes, and next topic is beta data validation. What is data validation? Data validation is used to restrict the type of data or a value that users enter a cell. Okay, beta, just with the concept of data validation, we know that the type of data or the value we enter, okay, that users enter a cell. We are the users, we enter the cell. Data validation gives us the restriction on that type of value. D means restriction. What kind of a restriction it gives? It gives that we can enter the data to a minimum value. The value is decided in between the data validation. How the value is decided? Let us see. First, what we have to do, beta, we have to select the range between E5 to E13, okay, and choose a data tab. Once we choose a data tab, in the data validation and data tools group, we see that a data validation dialog box appears. And that's it. In this data validation box, you can see, beta, three options are there: setting options, input message, and error alert. In the setting option, you can see, beta, under it, three more options are there: allow, data, minimum, four options, and maximum. In allow option, we have to select the whole number. In data between option, we have to select, and it is selected by its own, that means by default. And in the minimum, we have to select the 0 and maximum 100, and apply these changes to all other cells within the same settings. Okay, so by just providing these settings, setting these settings under the setting option, okay, after that we have to click on the input message tab. In input message tab, what we have to do, when we just click on the input message tab, one box, text box will come, and in text box we have to type enter between 0 and 100. As soon as we click on between type and 0 and 100, okay, means in the input box we have to type between enter, whatever the values we enter, it should be between 0 and 100. Whenever we enter data, suppose data validation gives us the limit to enter the data, okay, because as we have given the minimum limit 0 and the maximum limit 100, okay, and if we enter the data just beyond 100, or we can say more than 100, then it will not take, okay, it gives us an error message. So click on retry to another value. Suppose we want to try some another value, we can retry it, okay, by clicking on the retry button. So this is data validation, okay. Our next topic is adding subtotal in database. What is subtotal, beta? Just with the help of which, just with knowing the concept of subtotal, one thing get in our minds that subtotal is actually doing the total of something, okay. In your books you can see, beta, in figure 2.12, first what we have to do, we have to make one worksheet, okay. See, let us read what is subtotal. Subtotal feature in database helps us to manage, analyze, and extract specific information from rows of related data. Means it helps us to manage and analyze the specific information, okay, and to apply subtotals, database must be sorted. Means first of all, whenever we want to apply the feature of subtotals, database must be sorted. Let us learn the use of this feature through the given table. Follow these steps. First of all, what we have to do, we have to open a new worksheet and enter data. Like in figure 2.12, you can see one record of sales executive have made, that how much sales they have done in the month of October and November, okay, what is their present sale, okay, and after making that record, what you have to do, you have to select any cell within the range and choose data tab from the same data tab option, okay, and click on subtotal option in the outline group. After doing this, the subtotal dialog box appears. And from that subtotal dialog box in figure 2.13, it is given you have to choose the month option, okay, and to calculate the sum of sales, you have to select the sum option from the use function drop down list. After doing this, in add subtotal to list box, select the sales checks box, okay, and then deselect the replace current subtotals option by clicking on its checkbox. This option overrides the existing subtotal if present, okay, and then the summary below data checkbox is marked by default. This option will place a total below the date of each month and click on OK. The subtotals will be displayed as shown in figure 2.14. So like this, beta, what I want to say, it by just clicking on the subtotal, what we can do, we can calculate the overall sales of the records in each and every month of the employees which are working in the company, okay. We can also, not only about the sales, we can also make a record of the students, okay, in each and every month by using the feature of database in subtotal in a database. So beta, today we are going to learn till here only, okay, and rest we will discuss in the next class, okay beta. Till then you can revise the concepts of today, okay class.